I saw last Thursday, while at the National Assembly House Committee sitting on this matter, for the first time, the government, the custom presentation talks about breach of the peace or something having some religious implication. And of course, the chairman of the committee actually raised some concerns. That don't you think that your own very action of seeing this boss will lead to even the breach of the peace? Because I don't see how an artwork that people want to use for their own celebration goes to become something that will cause a breach of the peace. So but for me, what that shows is that there are still those within the system who have been the architect of the repression of the Ogoni people. And these people are still within the system who don't want anything around the name of Ken Saro-Wiwa to be highlighted. And if you recall that after the hanging of Ken, the federal government took certain steps. One, they ensured that Ken books that were written or that were read in the secondary school were removed from the curriculum, from the syllabus. You know, they had some of his books that were being read at secondary school level. They made sure those books were removed from the curriculum, all in attempt to erase the name of Ken Saro-Wiwa. So, for me, this is still the continuation of the war against Ken Saro-Wiwa and against the Ogoni people, just to ensure that name like that is completely obliterated from the sight of the Nigerian people. That is one dimension. And that is where we feel disenchanted, that even when we expected that there should have been a change in the approach to dealing with us as members of society, that we are still seeing the high-handedness that we experienced during the military era. And that is why for us, we feel that every man with conscience to rise up is just a symbolic thing. But the fact that this whole thing is being held and treated the way in which they've done, that is a clear indication that discrimination against the good people continues. It's a clear indication that perhaps the whole question of minority question in this country has not been properly addressed. It's still a stark reminder of the fact that there are still those within the system. And interestingly, the man currently heading custom today was the only military officer attacked with that tribunal. So is it a coincidence that this same boss is being seized by the custom? So I think that it still shows that we have those within the system working against us as a people. We are deeply worried, and that is why you can see is that sense of urgency that made us to issue the ultimatum in the first place. Because as the UN report clearly stated, any delay or every delay in the implementation of the recommendation of the UN report, particularly as it deals with the issue of remediation of the global environment, is also allowing the carbon footprint, the pollution footprint, to expand. So that what that means is that if you do another study on the Ogoni today, perhaps the pollution footprint must have expanded, may have expanded beyond where it was as of 2010 or thereabout when the study was concluded. So the more the cleanup is delayed, the more the pollution footprints are also expanding. And that is the greatest danger we have in this whole process.
So the way forward.
The whole delay around this thing should be broken. Let the structure be announced and let this guy start work.
So who do you put the blame on? I know the government on that.
No, but at the end of the day, it is the president that leads on everything. So if anything is failing, if he has given a directive to anybody within the system to do it, then he takes the blame. He should call his people to order to say, this is what I assigned to you, what has happened to it. So there's no way you divorce the president from it.
So you want to say that the federal government or the presidency is paying lip service to this?
Well, I don't want to say lip service. What we are saying is that the delay should be stopped forthwith and let the structure be announced, because from the negotiation of July, August, it is this structure that will drive the process. You see, the intention of our UN report is that it is not depending on the federal government budget for it to take up. If we were in other climb, this should have been what we may call penalty. But here, because it came as a recommendation from a third party, maybe it may not be seen as penalty. Maybe like what happened in the Dome of Mexico OFP, you see that If a penalty, people have to pay some amount of money. But in this case, UNEP recommended a take-up grant of $1 billion, which was supposed to do the first phase of 5 years, after which this thing will be renewed. So it is supposed to be a contribution from a joint venture partner. So it is not depending on federal government budget for this thing to be, a take-off. And very well, we are surprised that this whole thing has been subjected to this level of delay. You cannot put up the golden line on your asset in the area of say without seeking for a free and informed consent. And that is what we said. Even if you have a legal license that was given to you, tens of decades ago, you don't want to know. As far as we are concerned, we have our free prayer informed consent that need to be sought, that need to be given, before we can do anything relating to our land. Of course, as normal, there will be those who want to show interest in taking over, and that is how the whole question of Benema Power came in. As far as we are concerned, most of share did not leave Ogoni land. On November 30th, 1992, the Ogoni people sent a demand notice to share and the federal government to say do A, B, C, D, or pack your stuff and leave the land. This thing expired on the 31st December 1992. It was a 30-day demand notice. It was the failure of Shell to do anything that was in the demand notice that made the Ogoni people declare Shell persona non grata on January 4, 1993. And those issues are still there with us. So no company can just get up now to say you are coming back to resume all operation in the Ogoni when those issues are still there. And that is why we said that nobody can talk about resolution of operation in the Ogoni, because Ogoni people have never at any point said that we are aligned or we are agreeing to resumption of oil production in the land.